This video is going to be about rewriting logarithmic expressions. So what I'm going to do is start out with three properties of logarithms. The first property is called the power property, and it works like this. Let's say I've got this log base b. B could be any number, but let's just keep it general. Log base b of a raised to the n power. And what the power property says is that I can take that exponent, that power, and make it a coefficient for the rest of the logarithm. In other words, I can rewrite this as n times the log base b of a. And of course, if I've got something like this, n times the log base b of a, I can go in the other direction and rewrite that as the log base b of a to the n. So that's the power property. Then there's something called the product property. The product property says, if I've got two logarithms with the same base, so I'll say base b, like the log base b of m and the log base b of n, I can combine them into two logarithms. I'm sorry, I can combine them into one logarithm with the same base, so base b, by taking the arguments and multiplying them together. So I'm going to multiply m times n. So the log base b of m plus the log base b of n equals the log base b of m times n. And very often when you've got a product property, you've also got a quotient property to go along with. And so we have a quotient property for logarithms. So this says that the log base b of m minus the log base b of n can be combined into one log, the log base b of the fraction m over n. So once again, I've used the two arguments, but instead of multiplying them as I did when I had the product property, I'm making a fraction, I'm dividing them for the quotient property. Okay? So let's take these three properties and look at some logarithmic expressions and see how they can be rewritten. Okay, so here I've got this expression, 2 log base b of x minus 3 log base b of y plus 2 log base b of z. Well, the first thing I see is they all have the same base, so I'll be able to combine them. And now, since they all have coefficients, I'm going to use the product property first. I'll take the coefficients and make them exponents for the arguments of each of the logs. So instead of 2 log base b of x, I'm going to have log base b of x squared. The 2 that was a coefficient now becomes an exponent. Then I'm subtracting 3 log base b of y, so I want to get rid of that coefficient. I'm just going to say that that equals log base b of y to the third. And I'll do the same thing with the last part. So I'm going to take the 2, the coefficient, and make that an exponent. And that will be log base b of z squared. Okay, so now I can start combining these into one single logarithm. So let's take the first two logarithms, log base b of x squared minus the log base b of y to the third. And I'll use the quotient property. So I'll rewrite that as the log base b of the fraction x squared over the argument of the log that was being subtracted, y to the third. And I still have to add the log base b of z squared. So that means I use the product rule, the product property, and I'll multiply x squared over y to the third times z squared. So that means I have the log base b of the fraction. So let's see, x squared times z squared over y to the third. Okay? And of course, I could take this and take it apart again and get back to where I began. Okay? So actually, let's do a different problem where we do something like that. Here I've got the log base 2 of a to the third over b squared, and that fraction is raised to the fourth power. So the first thing I want to do in taking this apart, into making it into a number of logs, is take that fourth power and make it a coefficient. So that means I'll have 4 times the log base 2 of the fraction a to the third b squared. And now I'm going to use the quotient rule to take this fraction apart. So I'm going to have 4, and the 4 is multiplying everything that I end up with. So let's put parentheses here. I'll have 4 log 2, log base 2, of a to the third. And then since this was a fraction, there'll be minus log base 2 of b squared. And now I want to take these exponents that I have for each of the logs and make them into coefficients. So I'll have 4 parentheses, take this third power, make it the exponent, make it the coefficient for that log. 3 log base 2 of a minus, I've got an exponent here of 2, so I'll take that exponent and make it the coefficient, minus 2 times the log base 2 of b. And now I can distribute this 4, which was multiplying everything. So 4 times 3 times the log base 2 of a will be 12 times the log base 2 of a, minus 4 times that 2 is going to be 8 times the log base 2 of b. So this is my expanded form of the original single logarithm. Okay, so what this comes down to ultimately is just making sure that you've got these three basic properties memorized and you understand them. The power property, the product property, and the quotient property. And then once you're sure you understand them, try some exercises where you apply those rules and you should end up with a rewritten expression, which means exactly the same thing as the one you started with. Okay? Take care. I'll see you next time.